If you've ever used MIDIJam before, you know it can be hard to get a good render from it. The program only allows you a maximum resolution of 1600 by 1200. Even when you try to record at this resolution, it doesn't fit on your screen, even a 1920 by 1080 monitor. Also, camera positions are very limited. Although there are a total of 12 camera positions, plus an additional autocam, which just alternates between those 12, there's no way by default to manipulate the camera's position. Maybe you wanted to get a close-up on the trombone, but because it's so far in the back, there's no way to get a close look at it. MIDIJam by default doesn't offer any anti-aliasing, making edges look rough and jagged. Also, that bar and text at the bottom, it can be a bit obstructing. If you want to get rid of this, you'll have to crop your footage even more. Now what if I showed you this? Custom camera position, widescreen HD footage, anti-aliased edges, a custom background, and no HUD. It took a lot of work to get here, but I'm proud to show you my reverse engineering efforts to MIDIJam. I'll show you all the steps that are required to reach this point, as well as how you can do this yourself to produce higher quality MIDIJam videos. The first thing I managed to manipulate was the game's resolution. Inside the MIDIJam folder you get when you extract a zip after downloading is config.exe. This program allows you to set the video resolution, bit depth and refresh rate, as well as full screen and sound. When you press OK to save, the program writes to the hwf.cfg file. Viewing this file in a hex editor reveals what is being stored. This first byte stores sound, 1 being sound on, 0 being sound off. Same with the next byte, this stores full screen. The next D word, or 4 bytes, stores an index of what type of resolution MIDIJam should run at. The next 2 D words store bit depth and refresh rate. So unfortunately, forcing MIDIJam to play at a specific resolution won't be as easy as typing in the values here. We'll have to figure out what this index is referencing. We know that MIDIJam reads this file on startup so that it can know what display parameters it needs. But the actual numerical values of the resolution must be stored somewhere in the MIDIJam executable. To do this, I'm using Hexray's Interactive Disassembler and Decompiler. Don't worry, I'll be sharing with you the modified executable later, so you won't need to do this. This program shows me the assembly code the program is running on, as well as the decompiled pseudocode subroutines that can further be analyzed. This process is very complicated, and to be honest, I really don't know a whole lot about assembly. Ask me to write Java instead. I started by looking in the winmain function. This starts the execution of the program. After scrolling around, renaming variables, I was pretty sure I knew what they were based off their values and how they were used, I opened one of the subroutines that was called. Keep in mind, this may say setup game now, but it was initially sub410c50 or something. All these variables that have names were generically named after their memory address, now renamed by me. Opening this function reveals some familiar values. These are the preset resolutions from the config file, and this switch case even includes the indices that we use in the config file too. Now all we have to do is edit these values. However, since IDA is a read-only program and can't recompile the executable, we'll have to edit the hex data back in our hex editor. I'm going to modify the 1152 by 864 screen resolution to 1920 by 1080, but you could pick any of these. Using goto, the address that contains the integer value is now displayed and editable. I'll just type in the resolution of my monitor. I'll also go back to the config program and make sure that I have the correct resolution selected. Keep in mind, this may say 1152 by 864, but really it's now 1080p. I'll also enable full screen, since the resolution matches with my monitor. Opening a MIDI file now shows the widescreen HD view. You'll notice the background is cropped since the texture wasn't meant for a 16x9 display. We'll fix this later. The next thing we'll fix is the game's aliasing problem. It aliases horribly, especially on areas of high complexity like the harp strings. The process for fixing this is actually independent of MIDIJam. It lies in your graphics hardware settings. I have a GTX 1060, so I can find its settings by right-clicking on my desktop, then clicking NVIDIA Control Panel. This will be different for you if you have something other than NVIDIA graphics hardware. After clicking Manage 3D Settings, I can go to Program Settings, where I can change specific settings for MIDIJam. In here, I made sure to have every setting at the maximum, especially on isotropic filtering and anti-aliasing. After changing these settings, MIDIJam instantly begins rendering with much better quality. Removing the HUD involved editing the contents of the MIDIJam.hwf file. This file contains all the 3D models and textures that the program uses. I'm still not sure what program made this type of file, but I was able to figure out its structure. The file starts with raw data for the first 3D model, accordionfold.ms3d. Once the data is done for that file, the next file starts right after it. This repeats for each 3D model, then each texture, stored as bitmaps. After all the textures are stored, indices telling MIDIJam where each file starts and ends follows. I'm still not exactly sure the structure of this last section, but I'll tell you what I do know. Each file starts with the name of the file. In this case, the first file is accordionfold.ms3d. Then what appears to follow is garbage data. This garbage data is variable in size, and nothing seems to point how long it should last. However, the last 4 bytes of this garbage data is not garbage. It is the length of the file that was previously referenced. In this case, this D word in Little Endian means 9759, which represents the amount of bytes that file uses. Then the next file starts. Everything you see in MIDIJam is a 3D model except for the text. Even the progress bar and the red progress. We can use this to our advantage. By looking in the HWF file, we can find the 3D model for the progress bar and copy-paste the data into a new file. Opening this in Milkshape 3D, we can delete all the vertices and resave the file. This way, the progress bar has no visible surface. Copy-pasting the data back in and changing the value that states how many bytes long the file is successfully removes the bar. Repeat this for the red progress bar, and it's gone. You might be thinking, why not just delete the progress bar 3D model or texture? I tried both. Deleting the 3D model will result in MIDIJam crashing on startup, and deleting the texture will just replace it with a white block. The steps for removing the background were similar for removing the HUD. Extracting the bitmap and just changing it to all black was simple enough. Then re-importing was easy, since the size didn't change, I didn't have to adjust the size value. Long story short, I used Cheat Engine to find the specific address of the camera XYZ coordinates. I then wrote a Lua script that allows you to manipulate the camera's movement with the WASD keys. To rotate the camera, you can use numpad 8, 4, 5, and 6. If you notice the camera's a bit glitchy and flashy, that's the best I can get for now. I'm gonna try to improve this later. Since OpenGL uses GLU LookAt to manipulate the camera, there's a lot of trigonometry involved to get the camera pointing in the right direction. Install Cheat Engine and load the cheat table found in the description. Open the Lua script and press Execute Script to launch it. Press Enter to put the camera in Freecam mode. Don't try to move the camera when you're in one of the preset number cameras, it won't work. After pressing Enter, use WASD and numpad 8456 to move and rotate the camera. Press Enter at any time to go back to 0, and press F4 to stop the script. I've made a GitHub project and will be adding repositories for the Lua script and the modified files. If you want to help, feel free to submit some issues or pull requests. Also, I've started a new Discord server just for MIDIJam. You can post your videos there, discuss topics, and I'll be posting more resources there and will answer some of your questions regarding the program. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. It would mean a lot to me as I'm striving for 1,000 subscribers. Also, click the bell so you know when I post next. Thank you again for watching, and I'll see you next time.